Okay, hello everybody and welcome to my world. Bienvenidos a mi mundo. Yo soy Alicia y estoy con la gran actriz, comediante, flamenco, tanta cosa, Inma Heredia. This is my show and I am welcoming my great friend, the wonderful actress, the wonderful host, the wonderful comedian, and a supporter of Dani Sarte, who I've worked with for many years because she is so talented. With us, we have Inma Heredia from Sevilla, España.
Oh, wow. Thank you, Alicia, for the wonderful introduction. It's a pleasure to be in your show. Muchísimas gracias por la invitación. Y qué sorpresa del día estar contigo en tu show. Excelente.
En mi podcast, en mi nueva serie.
Maravillosa.
Yes. So Inma is going to tell us a little about herself for the people, the few of you in the world that don't know her. Nos va a contar Inma un poco de ella, porque yo sé mucho de ella. Yo sé, espera, déjame contar y después tú le añades. I'm going to talk a little about Inma because she is a wonderful, first of all, human being.
Thank you.
She is very soulful and very correct and very talented. She was my first person I thought of when I created Sol y Luna, which is Sol y Luna, un viaje mágico por los cinco continentes. This was my play. Well, it's still going to be traveling once we get rid of everything. And she's been in many other shows. She was the star of 2019 Lorca. ¿Cuál era? Lorca Vive.
Lorca Vive, Lorca Lives.
Lorca Vive at La Nacional. And now she's going to be in space and virtually you will see her there. So I will give the word to Inma and I will give her the speaker view. So Inma, adelante, in English and español.
In everything, muy bien, porque somos orgullosamente bilingües, lo cual es maravilloso. Bueno, multilingües. Mientras más idiomas hablemos, tanto tú como yo hablamos varios idiomas, más podemos comunicarnos con el mundo. So thank you for your wonderful introduction and for saying I'm a human being first, because that comes before being everything else. So thank you, thank you, thank you. And I feel that's my passion in the arts, is that it brings everybody together as human beings. And that's why we keep at it and we keep on going. And I'm so grateful that you are also incorporating the virtual elements in Lorca this year. Because that way I can be part of it. And of course, Dani Sarte wouldn't do a show that I had the opportunity to be in. And I would not, you know, of course I have to say yes. I love working with Alicia, with her team. You always create a wonderful collaborative spirit among all artists. And, you know, from what I hear, this year is going to be just amazing. And I am so happy to be part of it. And to bring a little bit of my essence as an artist and of my love for Lorca to the world, to keep celebrating the arts and what we live for, to just keep doing what we love and bring people together virtually, in person, of course, following safety protocols, and just do what we love and bring it on.
Right. I agree. I thank you. I thank you for always being part. I think last year, when it became all of a sudden, we had to do everything virtually. Teníamos que hacerlo virtualmente. You weren't prepared yet. So we did show some of what you did in 2019. So you were part of what we had. This year, our festival, like you said, como dijo, va a ser en persona y virtual. And we're going to combine it. We're going to see how that you know, that works, because we're only allowed to have certain number of people. Maybe by June, we're going to be like 75% or full, but I still am going to have everything socially separated. And this will be at La Nacional, aquí en Nueva York, en la calle 14, un sitio que nos han brindado pues, ayuda a organizarte para presentar este festival. So, Inma, this year you are doing what?
Oh, okay. So I've been doing a lot of things virtually. Like I've been collaborating with the organization of Latin actors. We say hello to Ola and we'll make sure to invite everybody to support this wonderful Lorca tribute with Danizarte. We've been supporting the diversity initiative. I've also taken part in Theater for the New City. They've been doing a lot of virtual shows and I'm very, you know, very grateful and happy to be part of the Theater for the New City family because it's also a theater that welcomes everybody with open arms.
Yes, I know. I saw you there in the street.
I do a street theater with them. Not now, but they always think of me because they are really, you know, they really walk the walk of embracing every culture, every possible form of art, and I've been collaborating with them as well, which makes me feel very happy.
Of course.
And then basically I've been also doing a lot of inner work, personal spiritual growth. It has been very important to me. I like structure too. I'm very artistic, very bohemian, but I also like structure. So it's like an interesting combination. And I know you understand it because
we
have both sides, right? The artists, right. We have our artistic side, but we also like to be organized. So I like to create my own schedules. And at certain time, I do my meditation. At a certain time, I say, okay, so this is relaxation time, or this is my reading time. And that has helped me a lot keep healthy, especially emotionally.
Right.
Because as sensitive people that we are, I feel sometimes we have been absorbing part of the collective anxiety and fear that's still out there. And the best thing we can do for the world is keep ourselves as happy and as healthy as possible, right? Because if we are happy, we can support other people in being happy and in bringing light. So,
right. I agree with you. I agree with you. I've made it my modus vivendi to help other people. I do it all the time. They ask me, I do it. You know, I know people are paid for it to be a consultant, but I do it out of my heart for new artists. Like, you know, Danizarte started like that as a place for new artists. It's going to be 30 years next year. 30 años.
So now they are not Danizarte. New anymore. They are very experienced, right?
Yes, very experienced. But we still are developing, of course, con esto nuevo. You know, I need help from my technical experts. Luckily, I've learned to do this. And I am very grateful for your participation. We have many artists on hand, you know, virtually and not virtually and in person. And it's hard to combine. We're working on that because it's going to be June 5th and 6th this year, 2021, believe it or not. But I'm so happy you are doing so many things. But for Danizarte, you told me, you are going to be doing a poem, que va a ser un poema, y también vas a cantar, ¿no? Para este festival. Y este festival se llama, I was going to say Danizarte Forever, I don't think so. Lorca Forever, Lorca por siempre. And tell me a little about what you're going to be doing and what's your...
Bueno, primero el título creo que es fantástico porque Lorca para siempre, Lorca Forever, truly symbolizes that. His spirit will always be with us. His beautiful word will always be with us. And yes, so many years later, it's still prevalent, ¿no? Todavía se puede seguir haciendo y tiene sentido. So that speaks a lot of his genius and talent, right? So this year, because I feel Lorca has everything, right? But because the world has gone through so much, I said, I want to choose an inspiring poem, right? So he loved Granada, And I found this poem as part of the play Doña Rosita, La Soltera, which is dedicated to the city of Granada. So it's very inspiring, very uplifting. Granada is a beautiful city, and we all have in our heart a city that we love. So the message is, yes, we love Granada, of course, as the land of Lorca, but I feel the audience can relate to their hometown, to whatever they love in their hearts, right? And how at home we feel every time we look at something that reminds us of our home place where we were born. So es el poema, y después también encontré una canción basado en el poema, porque habla de la calle Hervira, lo dicen con R, es Elvira, pero en andaluz, pues, a veces que la L se cambia por la R.
Okay, tell that in English, because that's a very interesting point.
Yes, so in the south of Spain, we have our own dialect, it's still Spanish, of course, but sometimes in colloquial, right, like the same thing, New York, has an accent too, depending on the neighborhood. Well, in the south, we also have our own way, which we speak. So sometimes the L, we make it an R. It's not that it's correct, that's oral. Right. So the title, because I did the research, the title of the song is with the R, Calle Hervira. It's not Elvira with the L, it's Hervira, the original title. So we're going to keep it the original title. Okay. And it's based on the street that is mentioned on the Lorca poem of La Calle de Elvira, donde viven las Manolas, who are Rosita's friends in the play.
Las Manolas, they are Rosita's friends.
They are Rosita's friends in the play, in the first act. They come to visit her and she dedicates this poem to her. But we're going to do our own version of the poem because we're going to do it outside the play. It can be done. It's done a lot, just as a tribute to the city of Granada, and of course to Lorca, who wrote it.
And let me say, because we're doing this before you are going to do your poem, which will be virtually. So this interview, I am going to close, and we will have a rehearsal. And I guess you have to come see the show, or you have to wait a while. One day we will put the whole thing together and show it online. But anything else you want to tell your audience? You're not going anywhere. We're going to rehearse. But right now, do you want to say anything?
Well, I just want to thank the audience for supporting Welcome to My World with Alicia and supporting the arts and being there for us because we love you. We do all of this for you with all of our hearts. And thank you for receiving the love that we as artists want to give. So thank you for receiving it and being with us. Muchas gracias al público que apoya tu podcast y que van a apoyar de alguna manera o en persona o por internet cuando esté listo, porque yo sé que tenemos público de toda la geografía del mundo.
Exacto,
que,
de todo, es un público internacional.
Internacional, que nos tendrá que ver más adelante cuando esté en internet, así que les agradecemos el apoyo y que disfruten de lo que nosotros como artistas creamos con mucho amor y con mucha ilusión para todos ustedes. Y mantengámonos positivos, optimistas y adelante, y mucha salud para todos. ¿Eh? Great health for all. That's my wish for the planet. Great health, yes, and joy. Thank you.
Okay, we'll say goodbye to the audience and we
Muchas gracias.
Will keep working. Gracias, gracias.